I'm thrilled to introduce our next guests. Beth and Brad Thorp are dear friends, family, and people who have created something amazing in this world. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having us.
I'm excited to share the Mitchell Thorp Foundation with our viewers and to share your story and to share the amazing work you guys are doing. You have come so far. So Brad, tell us a little bit, how did you guys get started?
Well, we started the foundation 10 years ago. Mitchell passed 10 years ago after a long 5-year journey of in and out of hospitals and trying to find doctors that would be able to help him. He actually passed undiagnosed, unfortunately, at the end of his life 10 years ago. So we're moving on, and I actually had two boys I coached when I came back after Mitchell's finally coming out of the grieving process that came down with cancer, a Hodgkin's lymphoma and a non-Hodgkin's lymphoma.
Teenage boys.
And they were both families were local, and they were all trying to raise money for their medical expenses. And at that time I said, let's form a foundation to help many.
Amazing. And so how has that gone? Because you're now the director of the foundation.
Yes, executive director. So it's taken my life in a whole different new direction that I thought was never on my radar, but now it is. And it is very rewarding to help so many other families and children suffering life-threatening illnesses and diseases and disorders. We've kept it non-disease specific because it affects the family no matter what the diagnosis is.
Right.
And we've had 100% success rate in keeping families together, which is very important to us, and not end in divorce or separation, because 78% statistically do fall apart because of the stress that the whole situation puts the family under.
So basically, the mission of the Mitchell Thorp Foundation is to help families in need with who have children who are in distress.
Yes.
Okay, and so because of that distress, you're saying that 78% of families actually come apart.
Statistically, that's the number, unfortunately. So
we basically come alongside these families, and we customize a program that fits their needs. Sometimes it's just not financial support, but it's the emotional support that we provide, because we've been in their footsteps and walking alongside them to help them, get through this journey.
I remember when Mitchell was sick and you guys were traveling, you would go from coast to coast, doctor to doctor, and it took over your lives, and it took over your finances.
It did.
And so it really wears you down, doesn't it?
Yeah, we truly understand, that it nearly bankrupt us. And when you get this diagnosis, you go to the end of the world to help, find a cure for your child.
So tell me about the programs. Tell us about the programs that you've instituted, because 10 years, in 10 years, you've come so far.
So far is right. When we first started, we started with one program, our medical and home assistance. Mm-hmm. And that basically helps families with basically anything that's not covered under insurance. Medically, we also providing for the home that they might need, just to keep a roof over their head, the lights on, food on the table. Our second program is our healing and rehabilitation. We've grown into that. We found that once families and children leave the hospital, a lot of times their ongoing therapies are covered, or it's so much more and above that what comes out of their pocket. But typically, like myself, one of the family members needs to leave their job to stay by that child's bedside. So the lack of finances, but the bills keep coming, and it's just this whole spiral effect that affects the whole family, right down to sibling support. And then our third program, we ended up 3 years ago starting a wheelchair conversion van program. So we've just got done honoring our third van. Not all families need it, but some do need it to transfer their children safely to and from, especially if they're wheelchair bound. And then we also have our fourth program, which we've grown into, which is our youth leadership, which is a servant leadership program. We have 60 kids in this program now, and it was all about kids like helping kids.
So healthy kids.
Healthy kids coming
helping
together.
And kids who need help.
They're our boots on the ground, so to speak, and help us with our mission, help us with our events. We train them in servant leadership development skills and what it is to give back to their community. And because we're a grassroots foundation, they get to see the fruits of their labor. So instead of a big national organization, sometimes I don't see how their donations or how their efforts are helping. So we can pull them into a lot of our family situations as well.
That's amazing. So I know on the screen we are showing some of the children you've helped and some of the families for our viewers to understand really the nature of the work that you're doing, because it's tremendous. And the fact that it's local, I think, is so important. It becomes very personal, doesn't it?
It does. And we've come to find that big corporations, sometimes they like to help local grassroots foundations because they can see donate local, and you can help right here in your own backyard. We have so much need up and down the coast because our footprint has grown tremendously. We're affiliated with a lot of the children's hospitals, all the way from Rady's Children's Hospital in San Diego, Chalk Up the Street, Children's Los Angeles, City of Hope, and all the way up to Stanford, Lucille Packard's Children's Hospital. So the need is great. Applications come in all the time. And naturally, in any type of nonprofit, we have to determine what's in the kitty and what we can do to help each family with just to get them through
the crisis. How do you get funded?
So we do two main events a year. We're coming up on our 10th annual 5K run walk, which is in Carlsbad, California. But you know, we get 1,000 people out there. It's a great event, just not a, you know, run. So it's a great family festival, along with, you know, the sky jumpers, and, you know, we get all the families
to
come
out. It's really grown since the first one.
Yeah, and we get the families to come out and thank the audience and for all their support. So that's our biggest one. And then we also do a Pillars of Hope, where we actually honor practitioners throughout the community in different areas that have helped some of our families and who've gone above and beyond the traditional medical, you know, role.
That's tremendous. And where can people find you? I know that everyone knows someone who's in need. Even if they themselves are not in need, they would know a family or a family member who could use assistance, and they don't know where to find organizations like the Mitchell Thorp Foundation. So how do they find you?
Well, they can go to our website, which hopefully you have it on the screen, but it's the mitchellthorp.org, and you can view our page. You can see all the children and families we're helping. This time of year, which is the holiday season, a lot of these families can't even afford gifts and things for their kids for Christmas, so we have adopt a family program, and or just donate to the general fund, and we in turn can help to get those gifts out to some of these families that wouldn't normally have a nice holiday season. But it just helps them throughout, consider giving throughout the year. I know you know all the different programs we have for that. We have our legacy giving, general donations, stock options. There's just a lot of different variety of ways to give.
And they can find it all on the website.
Absolutely. Find it all on the website.
Okay. Yeah. That's tremendous. Well, at this time of year especially, people are all thinking about how to end the year by doing good. And we're going to give them every opportunity to find you guys.
That would be amazing.
So that you can be, you know, on their doing good list. So thank you, Beth and Brad Thorp, for coming in.
Thank you.
And I'm thrilled to see you and share you with the world.
Thank you, Lauren.
And we'll be right back.